Fundamentals of Surveying, Q&A Review 2020. Question number 7. Your civil engineering, land surveying, urban planning firm gets a contract from the military to survey some bases on the Atlantic coast. Jackpot. But before you can collect the money, you've got to actually do the work. Ain't it a shame? As part of the contract, the DOD is requiring that the data handling procedures be outlined in an appendix. This is the exact same call to question as our last video, and I did that because oftentimes you will have a call to question with two or three questions asked after the initial paragraph. So here is our new question. It says, what subcommittee's data format procedures must the DOD follow, and what government agency supervises that subcommittee? Now, this is a standards and specifications question. Therefore, it is likely to be on both the FS exam and the PS exam. So get this one right, and you can do double duty. The choose your answer states, the blank subcommittee is responsible for managing the nation's GIS data sets. It is overseen by blank. Again, this is a fill in the blank with two blanks. If you get one of the two wrong, you will get 0 points for this question. And this question is made all the more complicated because you have 6 different answer choices, and you have to grab the correct one and drag it up to the box. And I have no idea which one goes where, and that's what makes this problem so difficult. But let's begin by defining some terms. The first term is FGDC, the Federal Geographic Data Committee. NCEES on the FS and PS exams are absolutely obsessed with the FGDC. They think the FGDC are rock stars, so they give them at least one question on every exam. At least it feels like it. So who the heck are these people? And why are they considered rock stars? Well, the FGDC is a subcommittee that was established in 1994, and their job is to coordinate the nation's data. So all of the metadata for GIS that is contracted for or created by the federal government, and much of the data which is contracted for or created by the state government, is required to meet certain standards and be available to the public. The FGDC's responsibilities are basically developing, managing, implementing frameworks. So checklists, procedure manuals, all this stuff about geospatial data. For example, all metadata must be in a TXT format file, and it must contain the following 5 elements. Although the FGDC's work is only required to be followed by the federal government, a lot of state, local, and private sector GIS people follow it voluntarily because it is some really good stuff. The FGDC are smart people who use common sense procedures to make good data. Now, the other side of this here is, who is the FGDC's boss? And this was really complicated to find. You know, it took me an hour to find all this information. But basically, the FGDC was created by the Office of Management and Budget. They are like the chief bean counters, the chief accountants in the federal government. And the FGDC has a board, and every federal government agency, defense, energy, housing, interior, transportation, they all come together and they all play nice in order to form an FGDC committee. But There can be only one boss, and that boss is currently the Department of Interior, because the Department of Interior chairs the committee, and specifically the U.S. Department of Interior, Bureau of Land Management, Geographic Sciences team currently leads the FGDC subcommittee. So now let's go back to our possible questions and let's fill in the blank. Specifically, the FGDC subcommittee is responsible for managing the nation's data sets. It is overseen, or what I should say, chaired by the Department of Interior. I'm not so concerned about who runs it, but you absolutely should know a little bit about the FGDC because their standards come up often on both the FS and PS exams.